What is up, my fellow ratbags? I am BigWorm380, and we're going to discuss Vigor today. Vigor came out in the Xbox preview program on July 30th, so it's been out for a little over a week now. I've had plenty of time to play it, so we're going to jump into it, and we're going to discuss the good, the bad, and what the developers have coming down the pipeline. So let's go ahead and jump into this review. This is the Access Show. Okay, so let's talk about what Vigor has going for it. It's set in 1991 Norway after a nuclear war, but this isn't your typical post-apocalyptic, you know, burned-out wasteland. This is actually out in locations that look realistic, and they look current. They're not. Everything's abandoned, but it's not destroyed. They did say on their website that the environments are not copy and pasted from actual locations, but they're definitely based on them. So by doing it that way, this gave the developers a little more creative liberty to where they can create these environments that not only look pretty, but they make more sense as far as the gameplay elements go. In a nutshell, this game is very pretty. In addition to looking good, the devs at Bohemia Interactive have come up with a unique combination of game mechanics that set this game apart from other survival games. It's a real simple concept of loot, shoot, and get out. While there's a good chance you'll run into other players, there's also a possibility you won't see anyone else at all. The reason for this is you can literally exit the map, or encounter as they call it, anytime you want. And the fact that you can leave anytime you want adds to that tension, because not only do you not know how many people enter the encounter with you, there can be, I think the most I've seen when they had the counter up before the round started was 8 people. I think it's up to 16 players, but I think 8 is the max I've ever seen join. Well, now when you load into an encounter, you don't even see that counter anymore. They just have a countdown clock. So you have no idea how many people are in. And once you're in, you can assume there's 8 people, but there might be some people that come in, hit a couple of houses or whatever, and they leave. You could literally be in the map by yourself and never know it. Or there could be 7 other players, you know, looking to shoot you. So that is a main part of the game that I really enjoy, just that's a pretty original idea, really. This means you have to decide when you think you have enough loot and how long you're willing to risk getting killed by another player. Because once you die, you lose everything in your player inventory. This is my favorite aspect of the game because there's definitely a tension that builds as you loot more and more. And I can't really think of any other game that provides that sense of urgency. Especially if you go for the big prize, which is the loot drop that falls in the map at different places. Once you get that, you have to run for your life and hopefully make it to an exit before someone takes you out. If you do manage to make it out of an encounter successfully, you'll return to your base. Upgrading this base is actually the main goal of the game. As you gain materials and certain resources, you get to level up your base and make improvements, like crafting benches that speed up how fast you can make weapons, or other stations that collect materials for you slowly over time. This is a neat part of the game because it gives the encounters a purpose, and it really makes you want to push the envelope when looting and taking more risk overall. Now, as with any game, especially one in early access or preview, like in Vigor's case, there's going to be issues with the game. There are a lot of people in the forums talking about how clunky or awkward the shooting is in Vigor, and they would be right. In fact, the community rep from Bohemia Interactive said that they are focusing heavily on the shooting mechanics in the next update. In addition to the gunplay, people are also complaining about the lack of diversity as far as where you find loot. I've noticed when I play, one of the best spots to find loot is in vehicles. You seem to get the most bang for your loot buck when you're checking cars or trucks versus a house where you can check like 5 rooms and literally get 3 or 4 items. I've also noticed they have these huge barns where you would think there would be a treasure trove of loot, only to find out they're completely empty. There's literally nothing in them at all. You can climb up a ladder and there's a separate room in them and there's just nothing in there at all to loot. Then, of course, there are regular bugs that games have. I've seen reports of people getting stuck in the terrain and things like lag or rubber banding. One thing I found out also, right now, the max level you can get your base to is only level 6. This has some people upset because with the level capped, they basically have nothing to do. They're going to be raising the cap in future updates, but with no date given, players are kind of in limbo. They can still go on in encounters and get kills and loot, but they can't really do anything with it as far as the base upgrading goes. I'm thinking they're going to incrementally increase the cap until full release, so players aren't maxed out and basically done with the game as soon as it comes out. And last but not least, I think the biggest problem in the game and what people seem to be angry about the most is the teaming that's going on. This game, as it is right now, is supposed to be a single-player experience. Apparently, there's a lot of players who don't see it that way, and they're teaming up. This makes it very frustrating and pretty much impossible to get the loot drops. I had this exact thing happen to me in my last video. I made my way to the drop as it was coming down, only to have two guys end up with it. The one guy and me were shooting it out while his buddy got the drop, and then he turned around and started shooting at me also. It's one of those things where people find a way to game the system, and as of right now, there's no way to report players, and even if there were, you don't even see any gamer tags in the game anyway. So they would have to implement a reporting system and put gamer tags in the game, and, you know, I mean, I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do with it. The developers said they're addressing the teaming and said they're working on ways to totally randomize the lobbies. They've already started doing this, but the complaints are still coming in. So hopefully they'll continue tweaking that and it'll help with the problem. Now that's not all the developers are working on. As I said earlier, they'll be tweaking the shooting mechanics in the very next update, whenever that comes. I'm expecting it any day now. It's been about anywhere from 7 to 10 days between updates, and the last update was on, I believe, July 30th. So I'm expecting an update any time now. So they're working on general bug fixing, of course, and they're going to be bringing more content, including the Founders Pack rewards that we'll be getting for buying the game in preview. The devs have said they're looking at co-op play down the road. I'm kind of hoping they speed that up a little bit because it may help alleviate some of the teaming issues. But there again, some players have seen up to 4 or 5 people working together. So if you and one buddy are together, it's not going to stop 4 or 5 people. To me, this is a really fun game. I really like the fresh concept it brings, and I think there's huge potential. I'm also curious to see what they may add as far as the base portion of the game. I'd like to see it expanded maybe where you could have a community, like up to 10 players in your group or community at your base, a shared base, but like only pairs can go out and they can only go on, you know, 2 people from your community can go, but they have to go to separate maps, you know? It's just an idea. So what do you guys think? Are you happy with the game so far? What would you like to see added to the game? And have you been the victim of teaming? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like and make sure you subscribe to Jade Plays Games. And go check out my channel, BigWorm380 Gaming. Anyway, guys, this has been The Access Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, I'll see you in the next one. Later.